How many people get inspired by the brand?
Like you see, we raising money for scholarships through T-shirts. So how many, three of
not even about a T-shirt no more at that point.
What are you able to do? You know, you could just go give out, you go buy hamburgers from McDonald's and go give it out to the homies, rocking your brand. That's what it's all about.
Right.
Embodying what your brand is really about.
Right. You know, it's not really about the shirt. Being that.
It could be whatever you want.
It could literally be what you are.
Yeah. It's what you are.
So it's your daily routine. Like, you got the green, you got the blue on, he got the black.
People benefit from the brand. We're selling the message. We're selling empowerment. We're selling the message. This is what we're selling. We're selling the message. We're selling empowerment. We're selling the machine.
Self-accountability.
Selling self-empowerment. This is what we're selling.
Sacrificing for that message, you even get that deep.
Hey, that's what they say up in the wire, right? You're gonna sacrifice basically your time, anything to just rock that brand. You're gonna go stand outside of Apple when they drop the new phone or the new Jordan.
New Jordan, they're gonna stand outside all
night. It's not about the shoe itself, it's about what they're doing,
and that status that you have with it on.
The wire,
That's crazy. I like that.
And it's really in everything, I promise.
It is. You made it so simple when you just said it. You simplified it so small to where it's just like, now this is what you are doing. This is what you are selling. Now I got a whole different, I don't even need to go look for no more this, that. I need to find out how can I push what I'm representing out. How can I do that? And I could put on anything. Yeah. Gold mines, anything.
You can put anything on it, bro.
Yeah.
It could be the quality
is what you push.
Yes.
You see what I'm trying to say? You could put whatever it is, make sure you put that, like that's the slab of the concrete you lay down. You know what I mean? That's what it is. And then you start building on top of that. So it could be whatever
you choose.
Like, Walmart is low prices.
Save less.
Yep. They want everybody to be able to afford whatever they need. Right. Quality goods. And they could come there and get it. How was it for you? You know, what made you get into starting your brand? And how did you start your brand?
I started my brand from the start. My foundation was I was at school. I always did have it written down in my notebook. I always had the whole gold mines, what I wanted to do, how I wanted to push it, I wanted to do clothes, who I wanted to target. I always had it in the notebook. So when I met Cam, me and Cam talked about it. He had the people. He had, like, the people he knew from this, that, from doing this. He had cousins who do this, the Dark Brothers. They already had a fan base, stuff like that. So he was like, I got the people. I got the plan. Let's put it together. You know what I'm saying? And I want to say that it's now it's just me, and I feel like that happened. That was a blessing because Cam was able to venture off and find what it was he really wanted to do. And he found that, and now he's really exploiting that and blowing up with it. So I'm grateful how everything played out. And it's like, the way I started it, coming from that, I feel like once I put that first foot forward, I never turned back. Everything I did from that, from when I said I wanted to do it, everything I did was building on gold mines. So I picked up a camera, started doing photography. Why? To build and have some money coming in just for gold mines. I wanted my work money to be for me, and I wanted another consistent income just for gold mines. So I started doing photography. Ended up loving it. You know what I'm saying? So I started doing that for a minute, and photography just kept growing. Because every time I would do, gold mines kept growing. Because every time I do photography, I would have gold mines on. I always, everywhere I go, whatever I do, I'm wearing some gold mines. So that continued to grow. People started noticing it. It kept getting bigger. So we put a message to it. And when I figure out what message I wanted to put to it, we don't make excuses, we make it happen. So we then collab with the Cancer Center. And did a drop for them. It was like maybe 2018, October, breast cancer. We did a drop for them. Sold all these shirts and gave half of the donations to them, and they loved it. From that feeling forward, I can honestly say that changed me. Because that feeling of being able to I can actually drop a t-shirt, and I can give it to these people, and the smiles and the hugs. These people, I didn't even know these people. They just were coming up to me, hugging me. And that satisfaction that they gave me, I couldn't turn back. Like, I just got hungry. I can do it. And I was able to even put a gold mine shirt on NBA Youngboy just from doing photography. We shot photography for the Birdman, We Poppin' video shoot. able to put a gold mine shirt on Young Boy. So I'm like, man, these small things that I'm doing just by being there, just by taking that step and doing this and putting, like I always say, put that first foot forward. You take that step, you got to keep going. So I kept going. I'm seeing, I'm developing, I'm getting bigger, growing bigger. My goals that I was right now, I started getting past everything. What to do next? And that just led me to making bigger goals. And it got to a point to where I'm like, man, I can't turn back. That's what I want
to
do.
Speaking of NBA, shout out to NBA. We actually, it was crazy because we saw like somebody had our pants on inside one of the Dirty Diana video. And I remember somebody hit us up like, yeah, y'all closing a YB video. We like, huh, let's go see. And that was crazy. It was like all in there too. Like you could see it. It was like, man, that was up.
I saw that. And again, shout out to NBA Youngboy because when we approached him and say, hey, Youngboy, we got a shirt for you. Asked him no questions, said nothing. He said, appreciate it. Threw the shirt on. He threw it on so quick, I can honestly say he threw it on backwards. We had to hurry up and go stop him and say, Young boy is on backwards. The GM down side on the back. Man, in the middle of the shoot, he switched the shirt around and put it on. It was red long sleeve gold mines. And we like, we looking at it like we was literally in awe, like, that's wild.
That's
the biggest upcoming, right now, got our shirts on just by us being out here giving it to them. That easy.
You put yourself in position. That's a lot of people that's watching this, they need to understand that didn't just happen.
Right.
You were put in position for that to happen.
And I wasn't even, I don't cut you off, but I wasn't even out there for gold mines. I wasn't even out there for that. I'm out here doing something else, doing a whole nother hustle. And that opportunity just presented itself, and I was prepared. Yep. I was prepared. I was ready. I had the shirt in the bag. I already said, man, if I come in contact with, I really was shooting for Birdman. I really wanted to get a shirt on Birdman, but it didn't happen like that. Shooting for the stars, I fell and caught the moon. So it's like, you really aim for that? You might not get exactly that, but you're going to get right.
And why they be like, if you want to make a million, don't shoot to make a million. You got to shoot to make 10.
I'll shoot for a billion. You might fall and shot and make 100 mil.
You might shot and fall and shot and make that one.
100 mil or something like that, but guess what? I'm cool with that 100 mil. Love it. I know how to be comfortable with that 100 mil.
Yeah.
I know how to be comfortable with just not getting Birdman and getting Youngboy. I was ecstatic. That was a highlight of any of my whole career.
That's what's up, bro.
So it's just like I was saying, getting that first foot forward, being there, being prepared.